and 9. And it reads, shall you repeat after me? For ye know the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich, yet for your sakes he became poor, that ye through his poverty might be rich. The servant is from rags to riches. Look at somebody and say, God brought me from rags to riches. Hallelujah. I said, God brought me. Yeah, glory. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I don't give the governor the credit. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I don't give the president the credit. I don't give the state representative the credit. Thank you, Jesus. I don't give the mayor of the city the credit. Amen. For all that God has did. It's a very, very beautiful book, the book of 1 Corinthians. Thank you, Jesus. As Paul instructed the Corinthian church, he gave them some concrete information. Paul talked to the Corinthian church. Thank you, Jesus. And reminded them of a few things. Reminded them of some problems that they were having. Thank you, Jesus. And he reminded them to be thankful for what God had did for them. Hallelujah to God. But he also said, you got some difference. You got some problems. And don't ever think that saved people don't have problems. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. You don't have to go to prophet who are for nobody to let you know you got problems. Some people feel like if so-and-so is prophesying to me, I know that is of God. And they are telling you some things that you already knew. That's not prophesying. Anybody tell you something you already know, that's not prophesying. I see where you had some problems in your life. Look at somebody and say, everybody has some problems. If you have not, then I want to talk to you. I see where you have had some disappointments in your life. Well, who is it that haven't had some disappointment? You've had some financial problems. Well, who is it that haven't had some financial problems? Thank you, Jesus. But this stirs some people's ego when you tell them these things. Just stick to the word of God. Thank you, Jesus, and you'll be all right. It's just obey God's word. So Paul here let them know you have some divisions and you've got some problems, but I'm here to tell you how to correct them. And I want you to amend them, and I want you to know you can, they can be amended through by the power of the Holy Ghost. Thank you, Jesus. It is not nothing, no kind of problem, no kind of situation, no kind of division, whatever it is you got, you have, will have, that God can straighten it out. Now, whatever. Does not make mistakes. So Paul here talked to the Corinthian church, and And he talks about quite a few things. Amen. He got into the law and having difficulties in the church and council. Thank you, Jesus. He talked about that. He went to the Lord's Supper. He went on and talked about quite a few things. He said, you got some problems. Amen. But he also pointed them in the right direction. And I'm here today to point you into the right direction. Here he says, for we ye know the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich, yet for your sakes he became poor, that ye, or you, through his poverty, might be rich. Jesus Christ, amen, suffered through poverty, that you and I might be rich. He went through suffering that you and I might have. God did not have to do it, but he did it for you and I. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. He didn't have to come here and be born in poverty, born in a mule state. But he did it for you and I because he was concerned about you and I. Thank you, Jesus, because you and I was in a bad condition. But God loved us so. He cared so much about you and I. Thank you, Jesus, until he was willing to come here in flesh. Thank you, Jesus, that he might deal with mankind on their level, that he might walk and talk among men and women. Thank you, Jesus, that he might be able to redeem you. Glory to God. What the scripture said in 1 Corinthians 10:13, that no temptation taken you but such as is common to man.
Amen. It was good.
Thank you, Jesus. Amen. But amen. God has blessed us. He gave us much now. He gave us some of the best jobs. Amen. He gave some of us some of the best of education. We got degrees now. We've worked in some of the most nicest places now. Hallelujah. We live in some of the nicest homes now. Thank you, Jesus. We ride in some of the nicest automobiles now. Thank you, Jesus. We some of us sit in classrooms and teachers and amen and doctors and lawyers. Glory to God, and secretaries. We have those positions now. Glory to God. And you ought not to, amen, forget that. Thank you, Jesus. Sometimes that in time past, that was a place that you couldn't go in. I just might well tell you, thank you, Jesus. There was a place that they didn't allow some of us to go in. 4 and 5, it said, but God, who is rich in mercy, for his great love wherewith he loved us, God, who is rich in mercy, and because of his great love wherewith he loved us, he cared so much for us. Thank you, Jesus. Even when we were dead in sin, has quickened us together with Christ. By grace ye are saved. When we were dead in sin, when we were out of the will of God, when we were doing our own thing, when we were serving the devil in a big way, thank you, Jesus, the mercy of God, the grace of God reached down and got us. I'm rich now, hallelujah, God. I can walk around, amen, with my head in the air. I'm not saying that I'm proud, but I know what I got. Glory to God. I know what God did for me. I know, hey, hallelujah, I know he brought me out. I know he delivered me. I know he made a way for me. And today, glory to God, I can tell you, thank you, Jesus, that I am rich today. For God reached down and got me and made me rich today. How did he make me rich? When he put his spirit in me, he gave me a joy that I didn't know anything about. He gave me a joy, thank you, Jesus, that's greater than any natural materialistic things can make me. Hallelujah. He gave me a peace that I can't have. I don't care if I'm sitting in an impartial building. God made me sit in high places. He gave me a joy. He gave me a peace. He gave me a deliverance that I didn't have and I couldn't find it nowhere else. And he gave you a joy and he gave you a deliverance. Hallelujah to God that the man that got $50 million doesn't have. Oh, God. Thank you, Jesus, because I hear him sing that song. Say, this joy that I have, the world didn't give it to me. And the world can't take it away from me. Away from me. Yes, give the Lord a hand clap and tell him thank you. Hallelujah. I thank God for today. Hallelujah. I give God all the credit. Thank you, Jesus. I give God the credit for bringing me out of wrath and made me rich today. Oh, yes. I don't think nobody else should. Hallelujah. But a priest couldn't do it. The rabbi couldn't do it. Is Amen.